I have created a 3D printer that can print metal at home for just $100. With it, I've already made motors, jets, and multi-layer PCBs. And all of that is just a glimpse of what's possible with this printer. In comparison, if you want to buy a machine that can make the same types of parts today, it will cost you at least $500,000. And yet, the $100 price tag of my homemade solution isn't even the most significant thing about it.
But before I tell you what that is, we need to know how it works, and more importantly, how it's made.
For that, I need to tell you about electroplating, a process that dissolves a piece of metal in fluid with the help of electricity, and then deposits that same metal on the other side of the electrical circuit, where it can create a solid metal layer. Until now, if you would have wanted to electroplate a part with this process, you would have needed to fully submerge the part in electrolyte. The problem with this is that the metal particles can kind of go wherever they want to in the electrolyte, and because of that, it's very difficult to get an even coating across the whole part. So when you try to make a thick metal coating, you end up having entire regions of your part uncoated, while other parts look like this. Ew.
But don't worry, at this point I had the idea that will make you go,
"Damn it, why didn't I think of that?
If we only submerge a little bit of our part in the fluid, then we have only given the metal one place to go, and thereby we know exactly how much metal we have deposited exactly where. Then we just repeat this process and go around the part in small segments to ensure a nice even coating.
And I designed a 3D printer that does exactly that.
With the help of surface tension, it can create these electrolyte bubbles wherever we want. And by combining this system with a traditional 3D printer and some conductive filament, we can first print, then deposit metal onto that, and then print on top of that again and repeat the cycle as many times as we want with no human interaction. Right away, this lets us make multi-layered printed circuit boards at home. But why stop there? I have already made motors and even ionic thrusters with this system. Just look at this printer that uses a fully 3D printed ionic thruster as a parts cooling fan. People, if this doesn't make you subscribe, then what will?
Anyway, these things have a lot of cool features, but we'll talk about them later, because the real magic is in the machine that made them.
You see? This is not just about printing metal. From the start, this was intended to be a part of the self-replicating 3D printer, and because of that, every part of it has to be printable by the printer itself. Not because we want the system to be cheap or easy to build, but to enable it to reproduce and to multiply on its own, giving one printer the power to become a factory that can produce anything, anywhere, to save us all from the faulty supply chain, the middlemen, the scalpers, to be a gateway to the stars by letting us build infrastructure on other planets. That is why this is not just a 3D printer, but the heart of the new industrial revolution.
Now you know why it's so important to make this thing work.
And to do that, we need a 3D printer with the additional ability to manipulate electrolyte as well as do the electroplating anywhere within the build volume. For that, we need a tube that can move around and deposit these electrolyte bubbles wherever we want to electroplate. The metal that needs to be dissolved is called the anode, and this also needs to be able to move to wherever these bubbles are placed.
That is why I simply combined the two.
The pipe that transports the electrolyte is also the anode. And to make things even easier, the printhead of our normal 3D printer can already move in all directions. So we can just attach this pipe onto it and call it a day, right?
Well, almost. The problem is, when you're printing plastic, the nozzle needs to be at the lowest point of the printhead. And when electroplating, the anode needs to be at the lowest point. Otherwise, the printer will crash.
The traditional solution to a problem like this would be to use a tool changer. But that adds a lot of complexity and electronics. So instead, I made this bistable compliant mechanism. Just attach it to the printhead, and when you need to toggle between printing and electroplating, just bump it on the top of the printer.
I'm really pleased with this solution. It's so simple, yet so elegant. Something that wasn't as simple to make, but is probably the coolest part of the printer, is the pump for the electrolyte.
To transport the electrolyte, we need a peristaltic pump. This can precisely dose electrolyte from the bottle to the print and then back again multiple times during the printing process.
It's perfect for our application. Except, there's a problem.
The pump works by squishing this, a silicone tube, which is not 3D printed, and thereby it's not easy to replicate.
It works, and actually works perfectly well, but we want to change the world, right?
Hence why I created the first ever print-in-place pump. Yes, not only is it the first ever fully 3D printed pump, but it actually requires no assembly at all. Print it and use it! It works by replacing the silicon tube with this thin-walled membrane that can flex and pump liquids just like the silicon tube. Even hard and brittle plastics like PLA can be used. Anyway, since you cannot print a part that is already in tension...
Well, you know... usually.
The lobes on the pump are not touching the membrane during printing. But that means there are 3 points during a single rotation where the pump would not be engaged with the membrane, and backflow could occur. But if you stack 2 of these things together, like this, with the lobes staggered, then you can make a pump that is always engaged, and thereby stopping all backflow and even being able to create even higher pressures than before. At this point, I would not blame you if you were thinking that you would never have to buy anything ever again. But let's be honest, sometimes getting up from the couch and turning on the printer is the hardest part of the process. In which case, you should check out today's video sponsor, PCBWay, from whom you can order all your manufacturing needs without having to get up from your couch.
Well, we all love to make stuff at home. Sometimes we have to admit that we're not able to 3D print everything we need for all our projects. At least not yet. But don't worry, PCBWay has you covered.
5xE's machine parts, flexible PCBs, or even 3D printed titanium parts for your next project can be in the mail within just a couple of days. And as a cherry on top, you can even have your parts shipped fully assembled and ready to go. So, what are you waiting for? Go check out the link in the video description and find out how PCBWay can help you with your project today.
And thank you PCBWay for sponsoring this video.
So, before we move on to the last, but still very important part of this printer, where I will also explain what I'm doing here, let's have a look at some of the parts that I have already made using this printer to show you what it can do and what possibilities it can enable. This is an ionic fan. And for now, all you need to know about it is that the more electrical charge you're able to push through it without getting a spark, the more airflow you get. In other words, we have to try different shapes to find the best one. And with the metal 3D printing attachment, it has never been easier to try new designs quickly. So, while I wanted to tell you about both this print-in-place version and this one that has a parabola-shaped receiver, I quickly realized that I would like to talk a lot more about this than what would make sense in this video. So, I will instead make a full video on this in the future.
And maybe even pick up the race with a guy who's objectively wrong about tomatoes.
Welcome to the Ionic-Thruster War, sunshine.
This is an electrostatic motor, and it's essentially the simplest type of motor you can build. I'm showing you this part because some of the commenters on my last video said they would eat their shoe if I actually printed a motor. But no, actually. I'm showing you this because I used a different method of plating than what I showed you earlier with the PCBs. Instead of using these bubbles to control where metal is placed, we submerged the whole part in electrolyte by printing a cup around it. Then we moved the anode around the part to ensure that all sides of the rotor are equally exposed, and thereby avoiding buildups. Anyway, the eagle-eyed among you will surely have noticed that one of the paddles on this motor is not coated. Remember how electroplating works? The metal is deposited on the other end of the electrical circuit. That is why only the parts that are printed in conductive filament get coated. But it also means that it has to be a part of the circuit for it to work. I chose to do this by printing the conductive filament onto a conductive build plate. The easiest way to get a conductive build plate is by just flipping over the one you already have. Easy!
Well, turns out there's a reason why we don't usually print on that side.
The prints do not stick very well to that surface. And that is why the paddle was not coated, because that one piece unstuck from the build plate. To solve this, I decided to roughen up the surface in hopes of better adhesion. I tried sanding, electrode etching, and many other things, but ultimately I ended up immersion electro etching the surface with salt water. After all that, the build plate looked like the surface of the moon. But it still was a struggle to make prints stick. For now, it works, but I'm sure that the community will find solutions that work a lot better than what I could come up with.
And if you want to contribute or just join the conversation, there's a Discord link in the video description. People there have already made great progress on the printer that I introduced in my last video. The printer that can print onto itself. The Infini-Z.
The plan was to hook up everything to a single control board and have it working fully autonomously. But I didn't want to release this video any later than it already is. So, I have not done that part yet.
But, don't worry. Because I did validate the process with a Sunshine biocomputer.
Which is essentially me pushing buttons on the printer that could have easily been automated if I'd only had a working micro USB cable. Now, I have been working on this project for a long time, and it is not something I can condense into a single 10-minute YouTube video. So for that reason, I will upload a longer video where I will be answering your questions and telling you about a lot of the technical details.
That video is going to be available on Patreon. And if you're already a member, thank you so much for supporting me. This would not be possible without you. Anyway, if you enjoyed this, you might want to check out my other videos too. Oh, and don't forget to subscribe. And thank you PCBWay for sponsoring this video. I'm Sunshine, thanks for watching, bye.